Hey, I don't even know how many times we talked about productivity in a software team. And I mentioned multiple times that I strongly believe that programmers, technical people have to be measured, their performance have to be measured in order to keep them motivated, in order to keep the proper atmosphere in the team and so on and so forth. And we discussed how to measure the performance of programmers. No matter how provocative it sounds, I suggested lines of code as one of the measurements, one of the metrics for productivity of programmers, number of pull requests, number of bugs submitted, fixed, and so on and so forth. I even have a blog post about that where all of this is explained. But now I would like to tell you about something else, about the system which we developed and practiced over the last 2 years in a group of programmers, researchers, which I happen to manage. And this system we call Calibrated Achievement Points. And I'll tell you how it works. The main situational aspect is that the team is not a team of just people writing code. So the team is not targeted towards one specific product, which has a huge number of lines of code, many, many defects, many features to implement, like a traditional software development team. Instead, it's a research and development team. And research, R&D, so the first R means that some people basically write zero lines of code, maybe for months or so. And some people write more lines of code because it's a D part, like development. And some people do some research, meaning that they investigate something, they do some experiments, they try, they fail sometimes, but they still are productive in some sense. And the question is how to compare these programmers writing code and people doing research and people doing no research and programmers writing no code and so on and so forth. So we did it this way. We defined a list of achievements which anybody in the team can achieve. For example, a new product released, that's an achievement. Or you close a pull request, you submit a pull request and you merge the pull request, that's another achievement. Or you maybe publish an academic paper. So you write it, you submit it to the conference accepts it, that's the result of your research. Or maybe you do some experiment and then you publish some internal document, let's call it a technical report, where you summarize the results of your work, and so on and so forth. So in our case, that's the list is about 30 lines, quite long list of things which anybody in the team can achieve. And each achievement is very measurable, so there are no subjectivity there. So if the paper is published, then the paper is published. And we also specify what kind of conferences we take into account. So it's not any conference, but specific, maybe not a specific list of conferences, but we expect certain quality of the conference by some ratings. If it's the pull request, then we expect the pull request to be submitted and merged, also again validated by certain rules and so on and so forth. So this list of 30 lines, they are pretty objective. They're pretty well verifiable. So it's difficult to say that I achieved that and then and then we cannot validate that. So we can validate on each line. And each line has points. So how many points you get if you achieve this? For example, you publish a paper because you're the researcher, then you publish the paper, then you get, let's say, 50 points. When you submit a pull request and the pull request gets merged because you're the coder, you're not the researcher, so in this case, you get, let's say, 2 points. Because, you know, the amount of work to be spent on a pull request is way smaller than the amount of work for a full academic paper, and so on. So starting from very, like, big and important achievements, down to smaller and less important, according to the numbers which we all together agreed about. So we spent a few years on that. So the whole team, team leaders and people who have something to say, we were discussing this system, and we were trying to make the numbers well balanced. So sometimes there were arguments about these lines are overestimated, overvalued, and these lines are undervalued, and so on. At some point, the system became more or less balanced. So there were not many complaints, even though the complaints were always. So always some people complain about some achievements and some people complain about some other achievements. For example, programmers, they will always complain that you give too many points to researchers. Like, why do you give 50 points for the article if you give only 2 points for the pull request? I spend like I don't know, 5 days for the full pull request, and these guys, they spend like what, like 2 weeks for an article, and so on and so forth. So they constantly try to pull the blanket to their own site. But at the end, the system becomes more or less stabilized and more or less fixed. And then anybody in the team is allowed to do whatever they want. Like literally. So there are no plans. We don't push you anywhere. We don't ask you to publish those papers. We don't ask you to do pull requests. We just let you achieve whatever you want and report to one person who we assign to this achievements collecting. You report to that person when you achieve something. You get a technical report written and finished, and you go to that person and say, hey, I finished the technical report, give me 25 points, and so on and so forth. So this person collects the data, collects and accumulates the data into one long spreadsheet. And by the end of the month or so, the spreadsheet is published to everybody. So everybody in the team, they can see what's going on. They can see the results of everybody. So it's like a total score, you know, like in a game, like in a competition, like a sport. So it's like a ranking where you can see who is achieving what. And by the end of the month or half a year or a year, of course, that's a time to give bonuses. It's a time to decide who is the best achiever, who is not the best achiever. And we use these numbers. So no pressure, no pushing. We don't demand anybody to do anything. We just let them, research and development team, research and development people, do whatever they feel like they're doing. But the more they do, the more they report, the more points we give them. And one last thing is that why it's called calibrated achievement points. It's not just achievement points, it's calibrated achievement points. Because we understand that not everybody is equal in the team. Not everybody has equal skills. Not everybody has equal capabilities and abilities to achieve the same results. For example, one person is like 7 years experience on the market. Okay, 17 years experience, and he's the PhD. He published like 50 papers in his life. And that's another guy who is an intern. And that guy is just graduated from the university, so he barely can write some code. So two completely different, you know, calibers of people. So they cannot achieve, they need different amount of time in order to achieve the same result. So that's why we assign like a weight. We call it a weight for the person. So how heavy is the person? One person is, let's say, 100 points. Another person is 50 points. So when I'm 100 points and then that guy is 50 points, it means that I will get 2 times less points for the same result. So when I achieve something, we get the points from the table, from our menu, and then we divide that by my weight. So if I achieve 50 for the article, but my weight is 100, then I get, you can calculate 0.5 points. But that guy who has a weight of 50, and he also published the article, then he will get 1 point. Simple as that. And also, you know, these weights, how heavy people are, usually reflect the amount of money these people get. So usually when the person is, the weight of the person is 100 and another guy is 20, then this is more or less approximately the relationship between the salaries they get, more or less. Of course, it's not, it's not linear, it's not that simple, but overall, approximately, it reflects the money situation. So that's it. That's how it works. We call it calibrated achievement points. You can call it KPI, you can call it OCR, whatever. I mean, I don't know exactly what it looks like. I mean, what it's close to. But in my opinion, this system just very simple. All you need to do in your team is just define the list of these achievement points, define the menu from which anybody in your team can pick up the line and decide, okay, this is what I want to achieve in this month, and this and this and that. And just focus on that. And they know that if they manage to achieve that, they will get this amount of points, exactly that amount of points. That's it, very objective. The manager just doesn't need to be even there. Everybody knows how much they get for the results they bring. That's it, try it out in your team. Tell me how it works. Thanks for listening, stay tuned, bye-bye.